only the one color that matters, and that is the color of red, white. Focusing on the colors that unite us, USA.
USA. USA. USA.
Hello, 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 America. Pastor Mark here. I am so sorry for the delay. We had a major delay today, learning something brand new with our phone systems, and I'm so excited that I get to have a conversation with the world, with everyone that is watching literally from all over the world. Again, we want to thank RSBN.TV, Joe, and the whole team there doing a magnificent job to continue to support the initiative of the conservative movement that's taking place around this country. I am so excited that you've joined me, and I'm telling you, I am just blown away that we get to take live calls today. And I hope you are excited like I am, because I get to talk to you and I get to hear your heart and I get to hear your concerns, and I get to hear, you know, that we have some real supporters out there, and we're going to just ignore the trolls. So to call, they got great, we got a great team that's going to make sure that those trolls get off the air quickly. So anyway, I love you all. I'm watching you, literally. I'm watching you saying I love you. I love you all. I'm going to try my hardest to call your name out. Billy Ford, I see you there. Look at this. I'm so excited. This R, two thumbs up for you. Billy, listen, I am Nathan. I see you out there. So y'all just bear with me as I am learning this out as we go. But anyhow, I'm really excited that those of you who are tuned in, I want you to call in, because I want to have a conversation. I want to have a regular conversation. I got some big news that we're doing with the Trump campaign. I got some big news of what Trump is doing for African Americans and things that we're going to be doing. I'm saying the sound is messed up. People are saying the sound is messed up. What are we doing with the sound? We're fixing the sound, because I hear a buzz. I hear a big buzz in my ear, and I assume that we had this fixed out, but that's okay. We're going to get it worked out anyhow. Again, thank y'all so much for your patience, because this is something brand new that we're doing, something brand new that we're doing here with RSBN.TV. Let me know if we got thumbs up. Let me know if we got thumbs up on the noise, or we're still thumbs down. There's a distortion. People are saying there's a distortion. There's a locust sound. I love comments. There's a weird noise. Can Pastor Mark see this chat? Hello, Cindy. Yes, I can see this chat. And I don't know if you can see this or you can hear this. I never heard such a noise. Somebody said it's okay, Pastor. Carry on. Okay. All right. So anyhow, I want you to go ahead and call in. I think we're ready to be calling in. 864, the number should be popping up on your screen. I want you to call in, because I want to have a conversation with you. And I want to, and again, y'all just bear with us. Thank y'all so much. They said the sound is better. Praise God. That is exciting. The sound is better. Listen, we need as many supporters of Donald Trump and in the right side movement, the conservative movement, because we have too many people that are bashing Donald Trump. There are too many people that are coming against this movement. And I believe without a shadow of a doubt, I have so many believers that are standing with me that you are saying, Pastor Mark, I am standing with you. I'm standing with Donald Trump. I'm standing with this movement that says America first. Listen to me. Don't let nobody ever, ever, ever make you feel ashamed for supporting Donald Trump. Because there's a movement that is going on that no man, no woman, no Democrat, no politician could ever stop. Because it is a movement of the people, by the people, and we are taken over by storm. Listen, call the number 864 888-373-0001. I want to take your call. I want to talk to you. I just want to have a conversation. You know, I mean, first of all, we got to talk about Hillary's speech. Yes, I see you. I see you on there. We got to talk about Hillary's speech. What in the world was Hillary doing? The whole Democratic National Convention, it was disappointing to me. I don't know, am I the only one that's thinking this, but it was extremely disappointing because she painted this fairy tale world that really nobody lives in but her. I mean, this fairy tale world that nobody lives in but her, and I am trying to figure out what world is she living in, and she's declaring that Donald Trump and you know, his speech was dim and it was gloomy, and he painted a negative picture. No, he did not paint a negative picture. He is only speaking the reality. He's telling the truth of what's taking place. And I believe there are more Americans that are saying, I know the status of our world. I know the United States. First of all, let me say this. Hillary Clinton said we are scared. We're not scared. How can we be scared as Americans? We are the strongest, baddest country there is in the United States of America. And we are strong. We are not afraid, but we are the country to deal with. And I'm told we got our first caller of the show. That is Scott from Arizona. Scott, are you on the call, sir?
Pastor Mark Burns.
Scott from Arizona, I hear you loud and clear.
Hi, how you doing this evening?
Good, Scott, good.
I am down here in southern Arizona. I'm about 20 miles from the border. And, you know, we've got border fences down here, Douglas, Arizona, below Bisbee and stuff. I'll tell you what, you're doing a fantastic job, sir.
Thank you, Scott.
I absolutely love Donald Trump. I want to vote for him. I just registered recently in Cochise County. I'm 20 miles from Tombstone, Arizona, which is a famous town.
Yes, I'm very familiar. Well, I want to tell you, thank you so much, Scott, for your support. Mr. Trump desperately needed. You have a question or statement?
Statement, make America great again.
Yes. You got that right, Scott.
I like seeing you. Okay, sir. Thank you
so Scott, much. From Arizona. Make America great again. If you're on Twitter, go ahead and just hashtag make America great again. Thank you so much, John. We got John from Ohio. John, are you there, sir? John, are you there on the call? Okay, I'm not sure if we got John, if we lost John or not. But if John's not there, do we got Matthew from Nevada? Are you there, Matthew?
I am here, Pastor Mark. How are you tonight?
There is the man, Matthew from Nevada. So honored to talk to you, my friend, my second caller. History's been made here, just like Donald Trump is making history by destroying all of those horrible, puppet politicians. History's been made right here on RSBN TV. Go ahead, my friend. What is your question or your statement?
Well, I can agree with you 100%. I worked all of his rallies here in Las Vegas during the primaries, and the turnouts were astronomical. So anybody that says that people aren't supporting him are blind, deaf, or stupid.
You got that right. They're blind, they're deaf, and they're stupid. You listen, there is a such thing called the spirit of stupid, all right? It is real. You know, some people, and the beautiful thing about America, you know, you have a right to be stupid, okay? It don't necessarily make you right, but you have a right to be stupid. We need more Americans. And I just want to say this, to piggyback on what you're saying. Don't let nobody make you ashamed for supporting Donald Trump, because it is not racist to be proud to be an American. It is not racist to be proud to be an American. And right now, we don't need people who are so quick to be moved just by the color of your skin, but we're uniting as one people, as one voice. That's what this is all about. And that's why America is great. That's why America is great. In Las Vegas, I can't wait to come. You know, I've only been to Vegas one time. One time I've been to Vegas. I got there and I burnt up because there was so much sand on the ground. No, I'm joking.
We had a lot of great rallies out here tonight, and I agree with you 100%. There are so many people that are afraid to come out and say they support Mr. Trump,
yeah,
but they're going to vote for him. I had so many people at the rallies tell me, I don't tell my family or friends because of the backlash I'm going to get, but I'll be there on election day to vote for him. And they did here in the primaries.
Yep.
Over, you know, he won by huge numbers.
Yep, he sure did.
Caucus here in February. So, you know, they're going to be out there. But like you said, don't be scared.
Yeah.
It's your right to say who you're going to support. Don't let nobody persuade you or push you into a corner because you're voting for somebody that will speak his mind, say the truth, say things that are going on, things that we see every day. So stand up for what you believe in. That's all I got to say.
My friend, thank you so much for calling in, and thank you for being our second caller on the historic show. And yes, I'm agreeing with everybody. You stand up, be bold, don't be afraid, be strong, be bold, be mighty. Listen, this movement, this is ours to take, this is our battle to lose, and as long as we're banding together, we can win. Thank you, my friend. We got Gary from New York. Gary, are you there on the call? We got to make sure we get... Is that Gary from New York?
Yeah, I'm a Roman Catholic.
Okay.
From upstate New York. That's behind you 100%, Pastor Burns.
Amen.
My greatest.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless you, my friend. Well, listen, this is our time. And I'm grateful you're a Roman Catholic and you're a believer and you're standing with us in the religious liberties. This is why it's so important that we elect Donald Trump to become the next president of the United States of America, because our religious liberties are under attack. Our religious liberties, and I know you can agree with me, our religious liberties are under attack. And when you attack one religion, you attack all faiths. When you attack one faith, you attack all faith. This is why your vote is so important. Thank you so much for standing with me. And we're going to win the great state of New York. And I know you're going to help us do it. Amen. We got Jason from Florida. Jason, are you there? Jason, are you there from the great Sunshine State? Jason is gone. Okay, all right. So we're going to our next caller, David from Illinois. David, are you there? David, are you there? Well, while we wait...
I'm calling from Illinois.
There you go. Is that David from Illinois? Are you there?
No, this is Madam Gigi from Illinois.
Madam Gigi from Illinois. Okay, well, let's get it right.
That's right. I am calling with the RSBN family.
Okay.
And I just wanted to give a statement tonight.
Please.
And I just wanted to let you know, Pastor Burns, that I enjoy your inspiration.
Oh, wow.
At a time where people are so divided, and to thank you for all you do and pushing your message of peace and harmony and uniting the people of this country, no matter their race or backgrounds.
Yes, absolutely.
We are all Americans.
All Americans. Wow. Thank you so much, Madam Gigi. You're absolutely right. It is only together. This is the thing that I don't understand. Why the Democrats are race baiting. They are doing whatever they can to race bait, to pit blacks against whites and Hispanics against minorities. You know, it's all about race with them, and we don't understand that we're so much weaker when we're divided. And the message of peace and love, and that's the key, is to spread the joy and the love. How there's too much hatred, there's too much suffering that is going on in this world, that we need more people who say, listen, I don't care what color you are, I don't care what race you are, I don't care what you've done in your past, I don't care what you've done in your background, I don't care how much education you have, if you're a human being, I'm going to love you just because. And I believe you have that spirit, Madam Gigi.
I do. And, you know, I've said before, it's all about unity.
Yes.
And it's all about us as Americans to stand up together and to fight for what we believe in.
Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for calling in. Thank you for making, you just made my heart melt. I feel so honored and humbled with RSBN family and Joe and the whole team. They just welcomed us in, and we just, I'm so honored. Thank you so much for calling and blessing me with that statement, because there's so much hatred out there. We need more people who are bold enough to say, listen, Pastor Mark, I love you. And I say to you, I love you. I'm standing with you. I'm standing with Donald Trump. I'm standing for unity. I'm standing for love. All those people who are using race to divide us, no, there are more Americans out there that says, I'm standing with the principles that Donald Trump is standing for a safe America, for a united America, for an American that is one, where jobs are impacting all races, not just one particular race, but all race. Thank you, Madam GG. Calls are keep coming in. Walter from Florida, are you there, Walter? Walter from
Florida.
Walter, are you there?
This is Waterboy in Florida.
Waterboy in Florida.
Yeah, this is Waterboy.
Hello, Waterboy. Good to talk to you.
Man, from Mark, I'm enjoying your show.
Oh, bless you. Bless you.
You're giving me goosebumps, bro.
We're doing it together. Go ahead.
I know, man. Hey, I'm in love with Donald Trump. I think he's got the best plans for us.
Yes.
I'm just a little depressed about that. I call them the Democrats.
Yep.
What they're doing, what Hillary's saying on TV today, and just evading all the truth. But you know what I say about that? The truth will prevail.
Absolutely.
And you can't be lying your whole life and get away with that. So I just hope that, you know, God takes care of all this for us, because it's just not right what's going on over there in the Democrats, with all the left-wing media that just, you turn on the TV and it's just disgusting.
Yes.
You know, what's going on the media there. All they do is put the man down.
Yep, and that's all they
you
do.
You know, it's insane.
It is insane. What
I
about
think because Hillary doesn't have any issues to talk about, maybe. I don't know what it is.
Well, see, again, you got to remember, Waterboy, thank you so much for calling in, too, and thank you for your encouraging words. This is so powerful, a movement. It's all surrounded around people who love God and they love Donald Trump, and that's what's taking place. We are taking our country back. Donald Trump is the voice of the people, and Waterboy, your voice have been ignored too long. Now we got a voice in Donald Trump. And I want to just say this about the liberal media. You know, this is why it's so important that we support organizations like RSBN.TV. I want you to sow into them. I want you to put money into this organization. Joe didn't ask me to do this. Joe didn't say, Pastor, can you do this? None of that. I just know that we need more media outlets like RSBN.TV that is allowing you and me to have a voice, where liberal media was just dogging and speaking ill against Donald Trump and not utilizing the truth. They nitpicking over small things.
We want to hear the truth.
They don't want to hear the truth. Truth, absolutely.
We want to hear the truth. That's what we want to hear.
We sure do. Thank you so much, Waterboy, from the great Sunshine State of Florida. I will be in Jacksonville. For everybody that's watching, I will be in Jacksonville, Florida.
You keep up the good work.
Yes, thank you. Waterboy, listen, while you're there, I'm going to be in Jacksonville this Wednesday. Donald Trump will be in Jacksonville, Florida. I'll be there to speak and to do what I'm called to do, to inspire the people. So I hope to get to see you in the audience, meet you in person.
I got to work, man. I got to work.
Well, you'll be watching it live on RSBN TV, hopefully.
I'd love to be there, man. I want to meet Donald Trump. I want to meet you. I'd love to be there. When are you guys coming down to Fort Lauderdale?
Well, I know we're going to be in Florida a good bit. Again, that's one of the states we got to win. I know you're there to help us win it. But I know that
you better believe it. I already converted 10 people last week to vote for Trump.
Well, that's all that matters,
I'm
my
on
friend.
A mission, baby.
I love you.
I'm
thank
on a
you.
Mission here.
I love you so much, Waterboy. Thank you for calling in. Listen, I'm just going to tell everybody.
We're going to vote 10 times.
Well, no, we're not like the Democrats.
I just registered my dog to vote.
Yeah. Well, we're going to let the false lion for the Democrats. They do that, you know. But listen, Waterboy, thank you for calling into the show. I love you so much. I love you. Listen, I want everybody to know.
Thanks, man.
I love you, too. I'll talk to you later. We got George from New Jersey. I just want to tell everybody,
bye,
I love you. I'm thankful for you. And it's okay to say, I love you. You know, we need more people, men and women, just say, listen, I love you. You know, we don't got to get super deep with it. We don't got to give our whole heart out. Just, I love you. So for all the callers, I love you. We got my friend, is it Jason now from Florida? Who we have on the call? George. Okay, we got George. George, are you there? Did I lose you, George?
I love, because we need someone strong in our in Washington. We want to send a message to them to tell them we the people, whether we're African American or white, together,
yes,
we're one nation. We have to send a message and let the world know that we're not weak.
Absolutely.
Yes, I get like people saying, "Oh no, because friends of Russia." We have to be. We have to be united to fight these,
yes,
these fundamentalists and these fanatics. You know, I live in an area, Reverend, that as a Christian, I am a minority as a Christian because I,
wow,
live all my areas, Muslims, all of them. I'm nothing against them.
Right.
But I hear them, the hate they have for the United States. No, I say to them, if, you know, I have no problem with your religion, but if you're not happy, go back to your country.
Exactly.
My parents, my mother and father came from Cuba, and they left before Castro, and there was a capitalist society because of greed and avarice, that society fell. And if we don't watch out, we're going to fall too. So we need someone like Trump to go in there and put order, and we have to make America first.
Absolutely. I 100% agree with you. We have to make America first. This is why the Democrats are doing, they're using race to try to persuade those of us who are making us feel like it is wrong for us to be proud to be an American, and it is wrong for us to be proud of the red, white, and blue. And if we, and you know, what Barack Obama and the Democratic Party has done is they brought in so many different groups, which is okay, but they're changing the very fabric of what America is. And so those of us who are proud to be Americans, we're the ones that they're looking at like, oh, you're racist because you're proud to be an American. No, I believe this is a Christian country. Doesn't mean we ignore Muslims or Islam or any other race or any other religion. That's what makes America great. We can accept you, but don't make us feel like we've done something wrong simply because we are proud to be Americans.
And not only that, Reverend, but we have to look at what Clintons have done. The Clintons are only out for the Clintons.
Absolutely.
The people. And I won't forget 1996 when President Clinton, Bill Clinton, signed to do away with the Steagall laws for the banks. And that's why everything is such a mess. When we go back to everything, how my parents used to tell me how great. My father came in 1948. My mother came in 1952. They said America was a rich country.
Yes.
And yes, we've been through a lot, but it was rich and prosperous.
Yes.
And now with all this trickle-down economy and all that. What is it? All of us. I have degrees. I'm working a menial job. I have so many friends with degrees and menial jobs. I own student loans up the wazoo. I mean, the past generation didn't have that. And that's why I'm hoping in Trump, and I believe Trump is going to bring America first, bring jobs here, worry about our borders, and we have to think about ourselves. Otherwise, we're going to end up like Cuba, or we're going to end up like one
absolutely
of those countries. I want to see that.
Absolutely.
You know, and my mom deceased a few months ago, and she said, my only worry, son, that you will not see what I saw in my country, that America will be great for future generations. And Reverend, God bless you, and you keep on preaching and telling everybody, and I'm telling everybody about Trump. I can't convince any of us, but this is what I believe, because I feel a conviction inside.
Absolutely.
And the Holy Spirit tells me, you've got to do this, George.
You, sir, George, are a true American. You are a true American, and I thank you. I know Mr. Trump thanks you so much because it's people like you who are willing to be on the front lines and willing to take whatever the liberal left will throw at you, and you're standing for right, you're standing for America, and you're standing for our liberty. Thank you, sir. I salute you for what you're doing in the great country of the United States of America. Listen, I want you to continue to go ahead.
I love you.
I love you, my friend. I love you. We have Jason from Florida. Jason, are you on the call, sir?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
I can.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you
great.
Clearly.
I've been trying to get through. I got knocked off a couple of times. I just wanted to call and say I support your show and to say hello from all the folks in the RSBN chat line.
Wow, wow. Thank you so much for calling in. I really appreciate that. You have no idea that the energy of love and the energy of unity that's on this call right now. This is why RSBN is so important. It is so powerful that we gather people who are, you know, Hillary Clinton said, oh, Donald Trump's speech at the RNC is just playing on the fears of America and painting our future as doom and gloom. How in the world can we as Americans be afraid? We're not afraid. We are the baddest country there is in the world. We're not afraid. We're simply being prepared.
We're not afraid.
No, we're not afraid.
We're not afraid, and we're tired of putting up with it.
Exactly.
And that's what I wanted to thank you for, you and your family, because you have to go on mainstream media and put up with their abuse. And I just wanted to thank you for that.
Well, it means a lot knowing that I have people like you that are feeling the love, that are pouring the love. You are putting love in my heart, into my wife's heart. And when mainstream media comes at us, we know that there are real people like you, real Americans like you. Real Americans who like RSBN and .TV who are saying, we got you, we got Mr. Trump, and we're going to back you up. We're going to back Mr. Trump up all the way to the White House. Thank you, my friend. Listen, I love you. God bless you.
my other question, I love you too, Mr. Burns. My other question was, when are you going to appear on another mainstream media show?
Well, I tell you, I am, I'm actually tonight, I'm going to be back on Fox tonight. At 10 o'clock, 10 p.m. For those who are watching, I'll be on, what's the name of the show? Waters World with Jason Waters on Fox News at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'll be there.
I will try to watch that, sir. And as far as faux news goes, you'll be the only nice thing on that program.
Thank you so much. That means a lot. That means you really do. You bless my heart today. Thank you so much, and God bless you. Let's get Mr. Trump in the office. Stephen from California, are you there, Stephen?
Can you hear me?
I sure can. Stephen, are you there?
Hey, Pastor, I want to thank you so much for breaking down the race barrier that the Democrats are trying to create around Donald Trump.
Yes.
It's ridiculous.
It is. It
and
is.
The new world order, and I also want to thank you just for helping to expose the Clintons and how far their tentacles run with the Clinton Foundation and how deep that money runs. I think we need to forgive anyone that got caught up in that blackmail scheme so that we can end the Clinton octopus.
Absolutely. Listen, you're speaking the truth, my friend. The Clinton corrupt Cain, the crooked Hillary, all of them together, it is a tactical web that has been entangling our country for years. Hillary is bragging on the fact that she's been in politics for over 30 years. In reality, that's her downfall. Because we see, this is what my question was, why in the world would anyone vote for a politician who's been in politics for over 30 years and say, I'm going to do something better? I mean, we already know what you can do. We already know what you can offer. And right now, our country is in the situation that it's in because of people like you. This is why Donald Trump has merged onto the scene, because he is speaking publicly with millions of Americans and millions of voters are saying privately. And now he's given us a voice to voice our concerns and somebody that's going to speak on our behalf to those big businesses like the Koch brothers who are trying to set up a meeting with Donald Trump, and Donald Trump denied them because he is not going to be bought out by no few billionaires that's trying to control an election. No, his people are us, the people of America, and this is why he is going to win. And Clinton, crooked Clinton, and crooked Clinton, and a crooked Hillary, and what's Cain's nickname? What's Cain's nickname?
I don't know Tim Cain's nickname. I don't like him. He looks like Howdy Doody.
Well, listen, my friend. The Clintons are on their way out of the office. This is it. I mean, you saw Bill falling asleep during his wife's speech.
Yeah, I saw that. I thought it was funny. But, you know, and the other thing is that the Clintons, when they got into office, they got to the FBI files and tried to blackmail everybody.
Yep.
Because they had the dirt on everybody.
Yep.
And I can't stand that. I want them out of there, and I want all the senators and representatives that are good, honest folks that somebody blackmailing them because of an affair to not worry about that.
Absolutely.
And not let that exposed. And get America great again.
Absolutely. You're right, my friend. We're on the right path. I thank you for giving me a call, for the love that you're giving. We got to continue to motivate. What I do is I try to motivate everyone that I touch, everyone that I connect to, so that you will become energized and you will go motivate 10 people in your community, in your church, in your job, wherever you are. Just motivate people, and let's continue to build this grassroots movement that is American movement and not a political movement. This is what we're doing here in America. Well, I love you.
I feel the vibe coming through the phone. I'm going to let you go and get on the other callers, but I'm going to do the same. I'm going to try to enlighten everybody around.
Amen. Let's do it together, my friend. And everybody that's watching, just type together on your computer screen. Just type together. I want you to shout. I wish everybody can hear me, or I can hear everybody talk back to me. But together, only together, only together, together, together. Crooked, Killery, cocaine. Somebody just said Crooked, Killery, and cocaine. The drug family. Only together. Shout together. Do I got Carmen from Kentucky on the air? Carmen, are you there?
I would like to know how are you making out in the strides of reaching out to the black community and the churches? And also, could you give us a roundabout critique of the Hillary's America movie? And I'll take the answers off the air.
Thank you so much for calling. Let me just share this. First of all, I wanted to make the announcement a little bit later, but since you're talking about it, this Sunday, and I don't know if many of you caught it, but there was the first ever in the history of the Republican Party, a black church, an African-American church from Charlotte, North Carolina, had a rally, a town hall rally for Mr. Trump, in support of Mr. Trump. And I was honored to be there along with the North Carolina director, Earl Phillips, who is in charge of the campaign, Donald Trump's campaign in North Carolina. And he knows these wonderful people, this whole black church. They endorsed, and we sent it out, but not many in the mainstream media picked it up. Simply because of the narrative. They don't want to believe that black people actually support Donald Trump. They want to continue to promote 0% of black people voting for Donald Trump. And that's not the case at all. That there are so many black families in this country that understand Hillary has been doing black people wrong for so long. And now we're moving to a better life for all of us. So now, exclusive moment that is taking place this Sunday at 12 noon. This Sunday at 12 noon, tell everybody. You're going to see a promo to come out real soon in the day. But this Sunday at 12 noon, we're going back to the same church that's going to be publicly endorsing Donald Trump. But not only that, we have Laura Trump will be there. We have Laura Trump, who is the wife of Eric Trump. We have Katrina Pearson, who is the national spokesperson for the Trump campaign. We have Omarosa. Everybody knows Omarosa. She will be there. She's also the new director of African American Outreach for the Trump campaign. You have Miss Lynn Patton, who gave an emotional speech at the RNC. And you might have seen her video that has went viral on YouTube. If you haven't, go ahead and look it up. Lynn Patton, who's a vice president of the Eric Foundation, Eric Trump Foundation, has poured her heart out on YouTube with his very personal video. She's also an African American. And then you have Diamond and Silk would be there as well. Everybody loves Diamond and Silk, and yours truly. I will be there, and we're going to be there officially to accept this nomination on the behalf of Mr. Trump. It's going to be big. It's going to be explosive. We have a private meeting coming up this Tuesday where we got We're going to be discussing the five-point plan initiative that Mr. Trump will be rolling out with some of the who's who within the African-American community, giants within the African-American community. We'll be rolling out in the next couple of weeks, with these five-point plan that's going to be directly impacting black communities across this country. Mr. Trump will be a president for everyone. We're going to eliminate this notion that Donald Trump doesn't care about African Americans. That is a lie from the gates of hell. Donald Trump is a man that's going to be standing for all Americans. That's why when I got up at the RNC and I said those words, all lives matter, because they all matter under God. Not one life is more precious than another. All lives matter, and Donald Trump is going to make sure that all Americans are raised up. All of us come up together so we can make it to the promised land. I hope that answered your question. I'm really excited about these new initiatives that's going to be launched out. You'll be hearing about them, but you get an exclusive right here on RSBN.TV. Jane from Canada. Jane, are you there?
Hello, Pastor Burns.
Hello, how are you?
Oh, I am so excited. The first time I saw one of your speeches at the rallies, oh. I was so pumped. I have my whole family involved. We're going crazy.
Oh, wow.
We pray for you and your family every day.
Thank you.
We are just so thrilled to be in this battle.
Yes.
I wanted to address the concerns that we have of Hillary stealing the election through voter fraud.
Okay.
We're so concerned about it.
Yes, yes. Well, that is...
Is Donald Trump aware of this threat?
Well, I can tell you that the wonderful, wonderful team within the Republican Party and within the Donald Trump campaign are making sure they're putting systems in place even right now to make sure that voter fraud doesn't take place. Trust me when I tell you it is on the radar. And they are putting systems in place. I can't go too much into detail, but just know that America has spoken. Donald Trump is hearing the voice of America. So many of Americans have saying, we got to be careful with voter fraud. We got to be careful. This is what's taking place. They're trying to steal the election. And so now we got the Republican Party, the elite on board, and we have, obviously the American people is backing Donald Trump. So there are systems that have been in place, coming pressures. There are systems that are in place that are going to be make sure that we prevent any kind of voters fraud. So thank you for that, and thank you for bringing that to our attention. But we still want to be wise. We still want to be attentive. Yes, sir.
Like diamond and silk, our whole family prays every morning at 11:20 for Donald Trump, for Pastor Mark and his family,
wow,
and for everybody on the Trump train in this great fight against the New World Order. We really believe this is the first time America has a real choice.
Amen.
For a real president who loves America. We really believe that.
Amen. Well, I want to thank you so much for praying for Donald Trump, praying for me. Listen, let's do this before I let you go. Let's pray together while I got you on the call. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus for the life of this great man of God who is a champion of America. Lord, I thank you for his family, and I thank you for the prayers that he gives up in the name of you, God. And I thank you that you are blessing him, opening up new doors for him. So what you're doing for me, you'll do it for him and his family. I thank you now in Jesus' name. It is so. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I love you. I love you so much, man of God.
I love you too.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Richard from Pennsylvania. Richard, are you there, Richard?
Hello.
Hey, Richard, are you there? Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, I'm here now. Yeah, this is LD. I'm calling in from RSBN TV.
Okay.
Yeah, I bless you for everything you do. I thank your help for Mr. Trump. I don't know if anybody can get a word out, but these electorials have already been bought by the DNC, so I'm afraid that things may end up being like when Humphrey ran against Nixon, that the electorials took the vote.
Right. Well, it's important that I think what we really have to do is to make sure that we vote. It boils down to making sure that the voice of the people, we all remember what took place in the primaries, and we knew that the elite and those who controlled power were doing their best to try to make sure that Mr. Trump doesn't win that nomination. But what was able to combat all their rules and their regulations is knowing that the people voted. It was our vote. It was our voice. And if our voice is so loud, like this movement is taking place, it's like a rushing wind that's taking place. But as long as we stand together and we don't fall into the traps of the liberal media, we don't fall into the traps of those who are just bashing Donald Trump just because, and we stand together. This is why the colors unite is so important, that we really, really embrace each other. So what happens in one neighborhood happens in all neighborhoods. What happens in your neighborhood happens in mine, meaning I care what's taking place in your life. I care. Despite the color of your skin, I care what's taking place in your family's life. And we're doing this together. I don't think nobody can take nothing away from Donald Trump. I think we'll win it.
Well, I pray every day that this happens.
Amen.
And of course, another thing is I was a Democrat for 50 years, and the last 10 years I got sick of it and had to flip over, which many other people in my area had done the same.
Right.
I'm out of central Pennsylvania, and I can see most of central Pennsylvania for Trump, as Hillary just showed up the other day, and she only had 35, 50 people.
Wow. Wow.
And then now Trump is coming to town tomorrow, and far as I know, the place is going to be full. It holds 10,000, and it's already booked.
It's going to be, because America's waking up. America's waking up. I mean, the polls are reading right now, and America is waking up. Donald Trump is moving forward. Now, America, the majority of America know, again, what took place at the DNC is a prime example of how Hillary Clinton will run her presidency. Exactly what took place at the DNC, a lot of pageantry, a lot of shouting, and a lot of, you know, a fluffy feel-good. But in reality, people are suffering. We'll put up the mothers of the movement, black mothers whose children were killed, which was a disgrace, by the way. I think that was a horrible disgrace to utilize those mothers whose children had been killed by different police. And it wasn't till the voice of America was saying how shameful for her to have those mothers of the movement up there, but not have one family member of a slain cop. Until the very next day, they then quickly threw some people in the DNC to speak, because they knew they were not focusing on those slain cops. They were more focusing on trying to paint the narrative that black people should be afraid of the police force, and this is why black people need to vote for the DNC, and not the fact that black people are still suffering financially, the lowest economics, the lowest academically. Net worth of a black family is less than $5,000. The abortion rate is at over 40%. Black people make up 13-14% of this country, but over 40% of abortions are done by black women. It's a genocide of black people. They don't want to talk about the reality. They want to make it nice and paint and fluffy and say, oh, Donald Trump is painting a bad negative, negative view of our world. No, that's just reality. And we are under attack.
I don't understand how any person that calls themselves a Christian can support a Clinton.
Amen.
I mean, come on now.
Amen.
I mean, come on. Supporting abortion up to 2 hours before the baby's born. That's
come
just
on.
Atrocious.
It's 2 hours.
Beyond belief.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, she's up to 2 hours before birth that she agrees that the baby can be aborted. She said that on TV.
Are y'all listening to this, callers? Are y'all hearing what this is? We got to fact check that and make sure, because I want to do a whole show on just abortion. Hillary Clinton is saying that you can abort a baby up to 2 hours before it is born? I mean, are
correct.
You serious?
I can't remember the show she was on, but it was a recording of her from back maybe 10 years ago, and they had an interview with her, and they showed it. I'm not sure if it was on Fox. Was on one of the TV programs.
This is horrible. Well, that's why we can't make sure she's elected. We got to make sure she's not elected. We got to make sure she never, ever steps foot ever back inside the White House ever again. They're fact checking it right now for me. They're looking it up. But my friend, thank you for calling in. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your support. I love you, my brother, in Jesus' name.
Bless you and all the souls that listen.
Amen. Thank you, my friend. We got Mrs. Woods from New Hampshire. Thank you for your patience. Mrs. Woods, are you there? Are you there, Mrs. Wood?
Yes, I'm here.
There you go. I hear you. Welcome to the show.
God bless you.
Bless you.
You know what God brought us down here for?
What is that?
It's to love one another, to take care of one another, to respect one another. And not just that, we're all different colors. It's because we're God's rainbow children.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And I love Trump. My son never voted. My son never voted before, and he's voting for Trump.
How old is he?
He's 38.
38. Well, listen, I want to tell you, Trump has created a movement that is inspiring millions of voters who've never voted before. My daughter just turned 18, and she voted for the first time ever in her life. She voted for the first time ever in her life and voted for Trump.
I just love watching you.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Mrs. Woods, for calling in. And I love you so much. Let's continue to support. Spread the word. Spread the word.
I tried to spread it. I tried to spread as much as I can.
Keep it up, Mrs. Woods. I love you, and I hope to get to meet you real soon. Thank you for calling in. We have
I love you, and God bless you.
God bless you. Iowa, are you there? Hello. Tell everybody your name and the state you're calling from.
This is Cindy from Iowa.
Cindy from Iowa. Hello.
Cindy. How you doing, Pastor Mark?
I am so blessed. I'm really good now that I'm talking to you.
First of all, I have to say, I want to tell you how much I love you for what you're doing for Donald Trump. You and your family. Cindy. I mean, not just you, but your whole family.
Thank you, Cindy. That means a lot. We got to get him in the office. I'm very passionate about it.
I know. You know, and I loved him the first moment because of he made me believe in America again.
Yes.
And then when I saw you, you made me believe in God again.
Oh, wow.
So it's like a double whammy.
Oh, wow.
You know, it's amazing to me. It's just amazing.
You're gonna bring a tear to my eye, Cindy, because that's what this is all about. It's about bringing this country back to God.
I haven't thought about God for a long time. I was raised Catholic.
Wow.
That's sometimes a bad thing, but you made me think about God again. And I thank you for that.
You just made my whole week, Cindy. You literally just made my whole week. When all of the attacks come from all over the country, and primarily from my own black brothers and sisters from all over the country, to hear one person say, Pastor, I wasn't even thinking about God until I saw you. That makes it all worthwhile, and that makes it why I'm here, and it tells me I'm doing the right thing. You just really blessed me, Cindy. Thank you so much.
Well, and the other thing is, I get tired when they say like you're the black pastor.
Thank you. Talk about it.
That's me. You know, I don't see color in a person.
Amen.
Until they treat me badly, I guess, and then I see a race or a color. But other than that, you know, I was thinking the other day, if a genie came up to me and said I could have one wish, you know, my father's dead, I wouldn't have anything personal. I would love to have everyone be the same color.
Yes.
So that there would be no reason to say, you know, I'm white, I'm black, I'm Asian, I'm, you know, that would be the best thing ever if everybody was just one color. I don't care if it's pink.
Cindy, I think that's the key to beginning to eliminate racism. I really do. I said it. We got to get rid of the adjectives that we put before our name to describe who we are. Like you said it earlier, and mainstream media, and I said it on Fox. I don't know if you caught it, but I said it on Fox. I said, you know, most likely I'm on the lower third there, they probably have the black pastor that supports Donald Trump, or the African American pastor that supports Donald Trump. And this is not, I think the moment we begin to stop seeing ourselves or describing ourselves using these types of adjectives that describes our race, then we can begin to just start seeing each other first as Americans, as human beings, not the black person, not the white person, not the male, not the female, but just human beings. And we can begin to just love each other for who we are.
Am I German American? Whatever.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just an American.
Exactly.
But that's what I love when you talk about the only colors that matter are red, white, and blue. And
amen.
Get over the rest of the crap.
Amen. You're speaking it. You should be preaching, Cindy, because you're telling the truth. The only colors that matter are the colors of the red, white, and blue of this country. Amen. Listen, thank you for encouraging me, and thank you for sharing that. I love you. Good to hear you soon. Love you.
All right.
Bye bye.
Yep.
Grace from Pennsylvania. Grace, are you with me today?
Hello.
Hey, Grace, how are you?
Once I want to say, first of all, I love you.
Oh.
And thank you for your inspiration.
Oh.
It means a lot to us that's fighting for Trump, because we get attacked from every side.
Yes.
And to have someone that's there to support us, we need that.
You know, I mean, it's just too much attack that's going on. That tells you that you're doing something right. Let me just say that. If you come under attack the way you are, that is a sign that you're doing something right, because you ruffled up some feathers. And right now, the established politicians like Crooked Hillary and like Cain and those politicians who have sold their souls to Wall Street and they've left Main Street, which represents the American people. You know, when you're taking that authority and that power away from them, they're going to do or say whatever they can to say to keep us focusing on issues that don't really matter. Like right now, they want us to be pitying. They want you to be mad at me, and they want me to be mad at you because of our colors of our skin. That's what they did. That's the number one goal right now. Their number one goal is to keep us pitted and fighting against each other. Go ahead.
Well, you know, to me, there's good and bad in every person and everything. I don't care what it is.
Absolutely.
It doesn't matter. And the thing of it is, to me, being a racist isn't a color, it's your actions.
Say that again. Say it loud.
I said, being racist isn't a color, it's your attitude.
Oh, that's good. That is so good. I'm going to start using that. Because you just hit it right on the nail, Gracie, that racism is not a color, it is an attitude, which means you can be black and racist, you can be Hispanic and racist, you can be white and racist, you can be a female and be racist, a male and be racist. It is an attitude. You said something magnificent right here on this show. And I tell you, thank you so much for just being bold. Continue. Listen, my word for you, this, and for everyone that is watching, every black person, every white person, despite of the color that you are, if you see somebody that does not look like you, they have a different color, then I want you to go out your way to just embrace them with a kind smile, or a kind nod, or a kind, a word. You don't have to give them your whole life story, but just show kindness. Don't walk past them. If you're a CEO, or if you own a company and you're watching me, and you really are embracing what Donald Trump stands for, because Donald Trump stands for America, despite the color of your skin. If you're a boss, if you're a manager, and you have a someone that is coming to apply for a job, don't quickly. I know how easy it can be. It can be easy because we're comfortable being around people that look like us. I get it. I understand. But you want to go out your way to listen to them, give them an opportunity to explain themselves. Don't automatically cut them off simply because they're black or they're white or they're Hispanic or they're male or they're female. I mean, first of all, it's illegal to do that. But I also understand that it is so much easier just to ignore somebody because they don't look like you. If you're in the elevator with somebody, you know, and you see them, have a, you know, just a smile to them, you know, acknowledging. You don't got to pull out your cell phone and give them your social security number. You don't have to give them your whole life story, but just an acknowledgement that you exist. That makes people feel so much love, you know, they matter as a person. So you don't got to do a whole bunch. Just acknowledge that they're there. A small nod or a handshake or a smile even. And that changes some people's lives. You have no idea. Kindness should supersede any race, any color. So thank you so much for calling and thank you for making that point out. And I want to go to the next caller. We have.
Well, I just want to say
before
one
you go,
thing.
Go ahead.
The gentleman said about Hillary saying about abortion 2 hours before.
Yes.
The birth.
Yes.
It's true. I have it on my Facebook. If you
wow.
want to go look it up.
You have it on your Facebook for all of our listeners and viewers are watching. We have they're fact checking and they're telling us that it is absolutely true that Hillary is approving a motion to abort a child 2 hours prior to them being born. I don't understand how that even possible. I don't understand how any person of faith could even think about voting for when we understand that life is done at conception and not birth. 2 hours. Thank you so much for sharing that with me. And it's on your Facebook.
Well, you're welcome.
I love you.
You be blessed.
I love you. I love you.
I love you.
I love you. Amen.
Keep up the fight.
Thank you so much.
And remember, racism isn't a color. It's an attitude.
It's an attitude. You're going to hear me say that now. You're going to hear me say that. I love you so much. Thank
Bye-bye.
You. God bless
love you.
You. So we have one true word from the chat room from Michigan. Are you on there on the chat and are you on the call? One true word.
Hi, Pastor Burns. Thank you. God bless you, brother.
Bless you.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
I have a dear friend and a sister in Christ, and we are closest sisters. She happens to be black, and I happen to be white, but she is a strong Hillary supporter.
Okay.
And she's buying the line that Trump is racist and all of that. And I just want to know, how should I start to reach her? We've kind of just agreed to not talk about it, you know, avoid the subject, but it's starting to wear on me because I really want her to see the truth.
Right. Well, I could tell you, you have an uphill battle. And believe it or not, even I, as a black man in my own church, I have some people that don't agree. And simply because they paid into the narrative that Donald Trump is this racist,
yeah.
and in mainstream media. And so what I do is I simply say, you know, I try to pour out the facts, you know, and I don't know how the Holy Spirit can give you a way to present it to your friend, because I don't know your friend, but how you can present it in a manner if it's very dear to your heart. Let me just say this, just point out the facts to her. Facts, not emotion. And this is what I tell people who don't agree. Just deal with facts and not emotion. If you look at the facts is Donald Trump never said anything negative about black people, period. Number one, fact, okay? I don't care what liberal media try to paint out, and I don't care what somebody said they heard, that their cousin, their uncle, their sister, their doctor heard Donald Trump say, you know,
the
we got to deal with facts. And the fact says, one, Donald Trump has never said anything negative about black people. He has plenty of black people, black executives, black men, black women that are supporting him, has supported him throughout his years, his 70 years on this earth. Fact. Okay. People who work very close with Donald Trump. Fact. All right, there are people who are black and different colors. All right, number two, and they know him. Okay, number two, understand what the Democratic Party has done for the black community as a whole. We're dealing with facts again and not emotion. Fact says that the net worth of a black family in this country is less than $5,000. Fact says that black families in urban cities, black men in urban cities, there's a 49 to 50% chance that you're going to be unemployed. fact is, we're still the lowest academic group, the lowest lowest group to graduate from high school, the lowest group to graduate from college. We are still at the bottom of the totem pole. Why? Because we've had a system that has been set up by the Democrats. Social programs and policies that have been set up by the Democrats. They have been charge for so long dealing with minorities, and look where we are right now. Even with a sitting black president of the United States, a sitting black Democrat president, black people are still way off. We're dealing with facts, not feelings, not emotions, not, oh my goodness, he hates black people because he said Mexican. That's what people say. Oh, he hates black people because he said Mexicans were rapists. I'm like, can you really hear yourself? Right. let's say that sentence again. Oh, he hates black people because he said Mexicans are all rapers and murderers and you know. No, listen, we got to deal with facts. Number three, dealing with the facts of Mexicans. Listen. We all understand Donald Trump is not a polished politician. That's one of the reasons why we love him so much, because he's not your polished politician that knows exactly what to say all the time. He speaks from his heart. And the fact of the matter is, what he said was true in reference to the border being wide open, in reference to people are coming over into this country. When the FBI says there are over 700,000 to 800,000 documented cases of rape and murder and kidnappings from illegal immigrants, illegal aliens that have crossed over into our country illegally. And they have done murder. They have done rapes. Not all of them, but over 700,000 to 800,000 cases by the FBI, your FBI, my right. FBI. Right. So we got to deal with facts. We got to get rid of feelings. We got to get rid of my mama voted for Democrats. My daddy voted for Democrats. My grandparents were Democrats. Right. We got the picture of JFK on the wall. No, we got to let it go. Deal with facts and not feelings. And ask your friend to go look up the facts. Look up the facts.
Okay, well, I sent her some YouTube videos on Margaret Sanger, because she did not realize that most of the abortion clinics are situated in the
black communities.
Hispanic and black communities.
Absolutely.
And right. And so I don't know if she's watched those yet. And I see someone in the chat was suggesting that I take her to see Hillary's America, and I haven't seen it yet. And I want to do that. I'm just, I hope that she'll go with me. I hope she will.
Well, I think she will. You just take her and say, listen, I'm not here to make you vote for whoever. You got to vote your own conscience. But just understand, if you really want to help black people, you got to become educated at the facts, okay? Because right now, black people are suffering in this country. Minorities are suffering in this country directly because of what's taking place under the Clintons. And they've done it for years. And now she's trying to take power again. And we need to get past our feelings, and we really got to get to of the facts. Okay, so I hope that helps you out.
It did. Thank you. And will this show be posted anywhere in archives?
It will be. Yes, Joe and the wonderful RSBN.TV family will make sure this is there. I really hate we started late today, but we'll be there. We're going to continue to go to 9 o'clock today, so everybody can have their full hour. So we have about 12 minutes to go. But thank you so much for calling in. And yes, spread this word. Spread this show.
Thank you.
God bless you. I love you.
God bless you.
We have.
Love you too. Bye.
Bye-bye.
God bless you.
We have Hickley. Am I saying that right? Hickley from the great state of South Carolina. Woohoo! South Carolina's in the house.
Pastor Burns?
Yes.
It's Silky.
Silky. They do. Oh, Lordy.
Silky. I go by Silk and Satin on the RSB.
Oh, Silk and Satin on the RSB chat. Miss Silky is in the house from the great state of South Carolina. I got you, Silky. I got you. I'm sold. what can I?
Well, lots of love from all of us.
Oh.
I've just got a couple of things that I want to bring up to you if I can.
Sure.
In one way, Obama and Clinton have done America a favor.
Mm-hmm.
They woke us up.
Yes, absolutely. You got that right. They woke us up.
They made us realize how, you know, it was Trump that really brought it to the forefront, because he speaks to us. He doesn't speak at us. He speaks to us and he tells us the truth.
Oh, that is so good.
We knew we were in a mess. We knew we were in a mess. But we didn't know really why we were in this mess.
Yes.
Until Donald Trump explained everything to us.
Amen.
About the rigged system. And, you know, I could just go on and on about the rigged system. The caller or two before talking about Donald Trump being racist.
Mm-hmm.
If you speak to people that have known him for 30 years, they said he doesn't have a racist bone in his body.
No, he doesn't.
And the only time he is being called racist is when he's running against the Democrats.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, that's
the Ivanka said in her speech that her father is racial and gender neutral.
Absolutely.
And I believe it. I don't think this man has ever lied. I trust him completely.
Absolutely. Well, I could tell you this. At the time that I've spent with him, and I spend with him again, I'll be with him again this Wednesday, that in Florida, in Jacksonville, Florida. Every time he sees me, no matter where I'm at, he says, "Pastor, my pastor, get over here." He sees my children. He always tells my children, "Give me your kids." He's like a big grandfather to my children, And he's always kissing on them and hugging on them. And, you know, you can tell what's real and what's not. And, you hear it all over the news that I said, you know, I'm from the South. I know what real racism is. And because I've experienced what real racism is, not this stuff that happens up north and out west. But, you know, we're from the South. So we know how some people are. Donald Trump is not one of them. He is not one of them. I know what real racism looks like. And it's most definitely not Donald Trump. This man is so... I mean, people don't like that he tells the truth. That's what it is. That's what political correctness is. They don't like it when he tells the truth.
You know what Charles Barkley said about the Democrats?
Yeah, we've been...
You know Charles Barkley, the
basketball player,
player from the past. He said that poor blacks have been voting Democrats
for 50 years.
Years
and still
no
broke.
Poor.
Absolutely. 100% absolutely accurate. Been voting. We know what the Democrats can do for us. Now let's do something different.
Exactly.
Thank you so much.
And thank you so much. We love you with all our hearts.
South Carolina, my home. I love y'all so much. God bless. Frank, we have Frank on the call here. Frank, are you there, Frank?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me all right?
I sure can, Frank. I hear you loud and clear.
God bless you. The Lord has put you in a key position. You're anointed and appointed, and we all love you, and the power of Jesus is going to be with you in the Holy Spirit. Listen, at the rallies, there's one thing I want to tell you about what people can do to help. At the rallies, Mr. Trump should announce, you know, that all of these rallies are on RSBN. You could multiply your viewing, because a lot of people that don't get to see the show and the speech, they don't realize that they go home on YouTube and see this.
Yep.
And so we all tell everybody to look at all the speeches on the YouTube channel. The other thing is you should connect with Alex Jones, and he'll put millions of people with you. You're anointed and appointed. The Holy Spirit is with you, and you're going to help change America. The Holy Spirit tells me this. The other thing is, now that's a good thing. Everybody tell everybody. Also, you Christians, God did not give us a spirit of fear.
Yes.
We are to operate proud and to speak up. And the old Lyndon B. Johnson law that said that Christians can't talk about who they're going to vote for in church is against the Constitution. It's against the power of God. We speak out, and Mr. Trump's going to change that rule. And
the Johnson Amendment. For everybody that's listening, he's talking about the Johnson Amendment that changed the tax code that would penalize any churches, nonprofits, for publicly speaking out in their pulpit for one candidate or another. So what Donald Trump has said that this country makes up about 77% of Americans consider themselves some form of Christian, and yet Many Christians, Donald Trump said, you know, Pastor, how come, you know, we have all these meetings privately with some of these great leaders and pastors, but nobody speaks up publicly what it is. And, and we'd explain to him that the Johnson Amendment has caused fear into a lot of these leaders who I think should be bolder. Regardless of what the tax credit or tax law, whatever, says, like you just said, God did not give us a spirit of fear. He gave us power. He gave us a sound mind. But that's just for the listeners who are watching and those who are watching. That's what he's talking about when he means the Johnson Amendment. Go ahead, brother.
So one last thing is the main problem we're going to have with Mr. Trump against his other people. I'm an analytical computer person myself, and we found out through the Citizens Task Force working on computer fraud, the registration, it needs to be audited. Our registration fraud is the number one problem. You want to audit the list of master Republican registrations and master Democrat registrations, because what happens is they create fraud registrations. So during the election, they say, well, there wasn't any fraud because everybody was registered. But the problem is people register, even one guy registered 1,000 times. And I'm going to call it out the way it is. Alex Padilla from California, mm-hmm. he's a computer wizard who used to work for a satellite company, and he designed software manipulating the actual computer system, and it's already in the bag for.
I read about that.
We must demand an audit of the registration before the vote, and there's four states that'll take us. California always goes Democrat because it's corruption, and New York and Illinois and Florida, there's always corruption in the registration process, and that's where we lose, but we got to stop it. The other thing is that Deborah Bowen got paid a ton of money under the table by the Democratic Party last time, and she pretended that she was retarded and had a mental illness and hung out in trailer parks. But the secretaries of state in our country are getting paid off, and they need to be investigated because they're literally allowing fraudulent registrations to occur. They're getting paid to allow the registrations to occur. Alex Padilla, I'm telling him in my face, he's a criminal. I challenge him the truth, and everybody at Angels in Heaven watching, I say, did you get paid a bunch of money to allow fraudulent registrations to be registered on our master list? And he did. And he literally has readjusted the whole, he's in control of every single name,
yes,
every single business in California. So what we have to do is bust him, tell the truth, and we want an audit of all the registrations, Democratic registration and Republican registration, and you'll see the tremendous fraud. They use the one name, Jose Martinez, 7,000 times, and you don't have to prove. The online registration is complete open for fraud.
Yep.
Mexico, Argentina, foreign countries registered to vote in California for our president, and there's no proof. I mean, you can try it yourself. You get on there, just say your name is Jose Martinez, you live on Sunset Boulevard, you have no driver's license, no social security number, and you just check yes that you're a citizen, but they'll let you register. So there's online fraud, and then Alex Padilla is deliberately manipulating the entire system. Now, the other thing is the company Dominion voting machines is absolutely 100% owned by the globalists. Their headquarters are in Canada, and a lot of folks don't understand how this works. You go to the place, you vote, you push this little button, you walk out. I'm asking you a question. Why don't we get a receipt? You can buy a beer, you get a receipt. Why can't we get a time code?
Exactly.
So we can verify 14. Later on from the presidency of the United States,
yes,
that our vote counted. So Dominion vote, and what they do is they have these little people that are called programmers, and they walk in with this little code reader like you read a car, and they say, what's the score? And he says, 7,000, 3,000. Okay, they just trust them. And then they delete the data. So it's tremendous fraud. So what we need a voter fraud task force set up right now, not
yeah,
next week, to eliminate the massive fraud in foreign countries. There's people, I got friends that work with the DEA down south of the border. There's people from Mexico that have been voting for our president online through California for years. And you can vote 1,000 times. You can register over and over and over again in California and vote for Hillary, and nobody will stop you. The other thing is, I'm going to call it out. Bill Clinton is a criminal. He's been paying,
yep,
Britney Spears, many people for their master fan list. And then they put it in this programming software, and it literally takes all the names and clicks it over to a registered voter. And so Bill Clinton's committing fraud. He's literally paying cash for the fan mail list because he's got a few years to live. He's a criminal. And
yeah,
then an FBI and NSA, get on it, boys. But if we audit the registration
serve notices to all voting companies that do not delete anything, do not touch anything, because we're going to go through a fine-tooth comb. We'll take them. Those four states, 55 electoral votes, California, New York, Florida, that put everybody over the top. Romney lost straight because of 37 million illegal aliens were registered through fraud. He only lost by 5 million. That was popular vote. And it was all the fraud that was in California put over the popular vote. And then the electoral votes, same thing, because the registration is fraud. And then nobody is at all is checking in foreign languages. Vietnamese, all these different languages, pretty checked. I can say my name is, no offense to any Asian people. I got friends. I love everybody. Don't matter where you're from. You either love God or you
Amen, brother. Amen. Listen, you are absolutely right. You're hitting it right on the nail. We got to be vigilant. We got to get those crooked Clintons out of there. We got to get them out of the office. We need people to go and vote. Brother, thank you so much for calling.
We got to audit. We have to audit.
Got to audit. I like the idea of the receipt idea. I like the idea of the receipt. We got more callers on the line. We're going to try to get to everybody as much as we can because we're already starting to get out of time. We got Miss China from Michigan on the air. Miss China, you there? Remind viewers that RSBN will be at two of Trump's events, Columbus, Ohio, and Harrisburg, PA. So we're going to be, RSBN is going to be in two Trump events coming up. It's going to be in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, and Columbus, Ohio. So make sure both of them are at 7 o'clock. Make sure you be looking it out. And that's going to be starting. When is the date for that? Tomorrow. Make sure for everyone that is watching, we are getting close to the end of our time. I have so many callers on the line. I'm trying to get to everyone because I desperately want to hear your voice. Columbus, they're telling me Ohio is at 3 o'clock. We got Kathy from New York. Kathy, are you there? Oh, they're telling me China's on the air. Miss China, are you there?
Hello?
Hello, China, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Hey, China.
Hi. I'm in high school, and I'm just learning about, like, you know, Hillary Clinton and, like, Trump and all of this stuff. And I'm new. I'm, like, 18, so I'm just starting to vote.
Okay.
And, you know, I'm starting to like Trump. I didn't really like him before because I thought he was racist and stuff.
Sure.
But I think he'd be a good president.
Yes, and I think you would too. First of all, China, thank you so much for at an early age getting involved into politics. If you're in the chat room, go ahead and just say China, congratulations. Go ahead and give China some big high fives for getting into politics at an early age, at 18 years old. And you're absolutely right, China. Donald Trump is not the racist, and you're getting a better understanding. My children, they're young, 18, 19, and a 20-year-old, and all of my other children from the ages of 11 and up are very involved into what's going on into the political system because it's your future at stake, China. Your future is at stake, and you need to make sure you're voting for a person that's going to make sure that our country is safe. You want to make sure our country has an economic revival so that when you graduate college, you're not looking. There's so many people who got degrees even now, and I'm sure those who are listening can agree that people who got degrees, but they don't have any good jobs because the jobs are in China. They're in Mexico. They're in other parts of the world. And you want to make sure you're voting for Donald Trump because he's going to appoint chief justices. That means the Supreme Court is going to appoint chief justices that is going to look at the Constitution, not like a living, breathing document, but as the writers wrote it, so you can have a future. I want to congratulate you, China, for getting involved in the politics. Get out and volunteer at your local Trump campaign. Get out there, pass out signs, get out there and continue to you know, you want a strong person to be our president. You want somebody right now. We're at war. People don't want to talk about it, but we're really at war. ISIS wants us dead. And we need strong. We need a strong captain at the front of the ship to lead us to victory. Does that make sense, China?
Yes, it does. And for me being a woman, everybody wants me to vote for Hillary because we want to make history, you know,
right.
With Obama being my president and then Hillary being like the first, like wanting to be the first female president. It's like we're trying to make history, but we have to understand of like what she's doing and
absolutely.
how will she benefit America. And, you know, I wasn't big into politics then, but I'm starting to, like, try to do research and try to do my own research.
Absolutely.
My grandpa, if you want to get into politics, do your own research.
Don't, you're so right.
Certain news, like, programs or whatever, because they'll put out what you want to hear.
Absolutely. And you're the future, China. You're the future. Maybe you become the first female president of the United States of America, because we're going to make sure it's not Hillary Clinton.
Yeah. But
listen, I love you in the Lord. I'm thankful that you're 18. I'm praying that God continues to cover you and make sure that you connected to the right people. Make sure you connected to the right guys, that you graduate college without a child. I'm going to speak that into your life, that you graduate college without being pregnant, and that you're going to walk into a new life, a new place, so you can be everything God wants you to be. And if it's politics, I'm praying that God calls you to connect with the right people that will help foster that in your life. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you so much, China, for calling. Our next caller is Kathy from New York. Kathy, are you there on the call? We want to make sure. Kathy, how are you?
Good. How are you tonight, Pastor?
I'm so happy to hear from you, Kathy.
You don't understand what you mean to me.
Oh.
I am disabled, and I can't go to church.
Oh.
And your church comes to me.
Oh, bless your heart. Bless your heart.
Well, and that means so much to me.
Oh, wow. Wow. Well, I am so honored.
I'm a recovered alcoholic by 26 years.
My God.
My children have never seen me drunk. Wow. And it's so hard every day. And this little Sunday meeting gave me some hope.
Wow. Wow. Well, I want to pray with you right now, Kathy. I'm going to pray with you right now. And this is not a preaching show. I preach live every Sunday at 11:30. But since you're on the call, I want to pray with you. And because I believe even now that God is working. This whole movement, I believe, is a God-led movement. I really do. God is bringing people together. We're transcending race. We're getting rid of the blacks and the whites, and that's what the Democrats are doing. But God is bringing us together. And Kathy, I would have never even spoken to you if it wasn't for God bringing us together for Donald Trump. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm speaking life into Kathy's life now in Jesus' name. And Father, she's even right now, while we're live on this show, is beginning to feel the love of Christ that's filling up her room and reminding her that even now, even though she's disabled, she is not done and counting out. Even though she cannot, even though she's not able to move as fast as she wants to move, Lord, you still have a purpose and an assignment for Kathy. And Father, you are bringing her the right people in her life so that somebody she can pour wisdom into. There's people that are worse off than Kathy is. So God, you're sending the right people in her life that she can speak love into, that she can show compassion for, and that she can be a light into their life to remind Kathy that God knew her before the foundations of the world was ever created. And even right now, Father, I speak any ailment, I call healing in the name of Jesus. Everybody that's on this call, everybody that's on the chat room, just begin to type out, be healed in Jesus' name. Just type it out. Just be healed in Jesus' name. And I believe we're coming together. Even right now, something magnificent is taking place here on this political show. God, this is why RSBN is so important, so we can come together and pray. Father, I call it done in the name of Jesus. Kathy's body will be healed, and that she will find joy and love. And she's reminded now that we're hugging her. All of us that is on this show, everybody that is watching her, we're just hugging her. And you've been loved right now because you're valued, you're important, and you are a child of God. And I speak this life into you now. It is so. In Jesus' name, shout amen with me, everybody. Amen. I pray.
Amen.
Amen. I love you, Kathy. I love you. I love you. Don't forget, you can watch me every night at 11:30 on the Now Television Network. I own a TV network.
Now?
The Now, N-O-W, the Now.
N-O-I, okay, the
yes,
Now Network.
The
All
Now
right,
Network.
That.
Yeah, that's me. And so
every night
at 11:30, I'm teaching. And then you can watch me live on Sunday mornings, right from your iPhone, from your computer. It's called thenownetwork.org, and I teach every Sunday live at 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. 11:30 a.m. Eastern Standard. I'm teaching the Word of God. Like today, I taught on the size of your enemy will determine the size of your reward. It was a powerful word, and so I hope to get to see you on there live too. Okay, Kathy?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
God bless you.
Everyone, I love you.
We love you too. Goodbye. Amen. We have Lynn from New Jersey. Lynn, are you there on the call?
Hi, Pastor Mark.
Hey, Lynn.
I just want to start by saying God is good.
Yes.
And he'll carry us through anything.
Absolutely.
I also wanted to thank you and Lady T and your family for the message that you've been providing all of us. It's so uplifting, and we need it because the darkness has been shown in the light now.
Yes.
And some of the things that have come out are very disturbing. And in particular, I was watching your show a couple of weeks ago, and you talked about Margaret Sanger. And so I started researching it. And for 2 days, I researched this woman, and I was horrified what I saw. Mm-hmm. And I found pages from black pastors that talked about, Margaret Sanger and black genocide, and the statistics, how 78% of these Planned Parenthoods are in, low-income
yep.
neighborhoods, and how the black population is the only one that really hasn't grown.
Yep.
I think it's 12 or 13%, and in reality, it should be 35% more
Absolutely.
Than what it is.
Absolutely.
And then I went and saw Hillary's America, and that fact was also in there, but of course, I already knew that from you. And I sit and I can't even think about why anybody would vote for this woman, especially someone who is black.
Absolutely.
Knowing that Hillary Clinton said she is in awe of Margaret Sanger. It is on a YouTube video.
Yep.
It is in her voice.
Yep.
It is her words. She is in awe of that woman.
You are absolutely right. The thing is, again, what black families and black people, and I can't speak for every black person, but again, I can only speak for me. You know, we're very emotional. A lot of our decisions in a lot of cases, especially politics, and I'm going to speak for me and the black families that I know, we make a lot of decisions based off of feelings and not facts. Feeling says that the Democratic Party is the civil rights party, the party of the civil rights. And it is through Dr. Martin Luther King and JFK, who really didn't want to have anything really to do with the civil rights movement, but moving forward, JFK, and then later his brother Robert, and then of course Lyndon Baines Johnson, who infamously said that he would have those ends voting Democrats for the next 50 years, and he's right, he has. It is fact. That the Democratic Party is as they understand, systematically keeping black people in their place. And you are 100% right in how the growth of the black community shouldn't be at 13-14%. It should be at 30-35%. But over 40 million babies have been killed. Forgot my numbers right. Yeah, I may want to fact check me, but over 40 million babies, black babies, have been aborted. And strategically, Margaret Sanger started something back way back then, and it's having its impact now, so that blacks don't grow, and yet black people are in line, ready to vote for the Democrats.
Well, believe me, I already fact checked you.
Good.
And it is truth.
Good.
And it is a horrifying truth.
Good.
You know, one that I wish I never saw, and I feel sick about it, and I feel like so many crimes are being committed, and yes. nobody is doing anything about it, and I can't wait until November 8th, well, actually November 9th, when Trump is sitting in the Oval Office, and he locks her up,
yes.
and the rest of them, for the crimes that they are committing against America.
Somebody said in the chat room, I admire, thank you, Ryan, I admire Margaret Sanger immensely. Her courage and tenacity is what Hillary Clinton stated. Thank you so much, Ryan. You're absolutely
and also,
right.
And I also want to tell you that if you're looking for that Hillary about the unborn child just hours before delivery, mm-hmm. it's on lifenews.com, and it was from The View. She did a show on April 5th of 2016, and yeah, that's what she said.
The April 5th of 2016 on The View. She
right.
did on The View, mm-hmm. and she stated that you can abort a child up to 2 hours prior to it being born. Wow,
she said that's what the law. She said that's what the law states, and she supports Roe versus Wade.
My goodness, this is what we're dealing with. See, this is what they you know. Thank you so much for calling. This is what they do. They get us focusing on issues like color and race that really don't solve anything. But they keep passing laws like that, Roe versus Wade, and keep you know. Donald Trump said to me, he said, Pastor, you know, do you know that Christians are the largest group in America? They can lobby any law in this country, but we're so divided. And that's what the Democrats are doing, keeping us focused on division. They call themselves the party of unity. No, Donald Trump is the party of jobs. Donald Trump is dealing with issues that transcend race and color. And while we're fighting each other over race, ignorant, stupid stuff, calling ourselves names, calling each other names, putting each other down, fighting anger, bitterness. The those in power are passing laws, and we don't, and they're happening on our nose because we're so focused on stupid stuff like race that has nothing to do with with passing laws.
Well, that's why I'm so grateful for you, for RSBN, I'm from their chat room, and for Wayne Dupree's show.
Yes. Wayne is awesome. Wayne is awesome.
Together.
Yes. And we're going to keep
Diamond and Silk.
Diamond and Silk.
Them.
I love them. And listen, you're going to see, I'm going to be with them. I'm going to be with them this Sunday. It's going to be awesome. I'm going to be with them Sunday in Charlotte, North Carolina, the first black church to ever endorse Donald Trump for president. They are not 501c3. So they are holding a rally to support the Trump organization. Laura Trump, who is Eric Trump's wife, who's from North Carolina, will be there. Diamond and Silk will be there. Katrina Pearson, the national spokeswoman for the Trump campaign. Lynn Patton, who's a vice president for the Eric Trump Foundation, will be there. Yours truly will be there. It's going to be a magnificent. The Antioch Road to Glory International Ministries in Charlotte, North Carolina. It's going to be awesome. Now, I hope maybe we can get RSBN to broadcast it live because it's going to be an amazing day. Omarosa, she also is going to be there. The North Carolina director for Trump campaign in North Carolina, Earl Phillips, he's leading this. He's doing an amazing job for the Trump campaign in North Carolina. That's what's taking place. Donald Trump cares about all America.
Well, hopefully you all can come to New Jersey, too.
Oh, yes.
We need to see all of you here.
Absolutely. Well, I've got to get to New Jersey.
Thank you.
I love you so much. Thank you for calling. We got Mark from Florida. Mark, that's got to be a great name. Mark, are you there?
I'm here. I'm here in Florida. Mark White.
Mark, honored to meet you, my friend.
You too, brother. I just want to thank God for you, brother. What an inspiration to America that you are right now. I want to share with you, I'm a prison minister.
Okay.
And we do a pretty big prison ministry here in Florida. And we go in, we have several Bible studies. We do Sunday services. But one of our Bible studies, for example, we have over 80 men that show up. They're from all races, white, black, Asian. We have Spanish brothers in there. And this is what I've learned. the power of love cannot be overcome.
Wow.
And that's the message that you're sharing with America, is that love, God's love, is so powerful,
yes,
it cannot be conquered.
Yes.
So we come together in love,
yes,
and these brothers love each other. It doesn't matter what race, what color, because we're all God's children.
Isn't that amazing?
And I just want to thank you, oh, it's just powerful. It's powerful to see. And it's the message that you're sharing with America. That if we come together united and stand together with Mr. Trump,
yes,
and the message of coming together is all races, all colors, it doesn't matter, standing up for America, patriots, trying to do the right thing for our country, it's going to be an amazing story.
Absolutely. Listen, Mark, I thank you so much, first of all, for your prison ministry and what God is doing. He's using you in that capacity to bless those men, that they may be locked up in the natural, but they're not locked up in their minds, and you're freeing them and bringing,
amen,
them closer to God. So thank you, Mark, for that. And I just want to continue to just, you're right, it's love, 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 love. You know, love says it doesn't matter what race you are, or your religion, or your, you know, we have our personal beliefs, and for me, Christ is the way to the Father, but I don't have to hate you because you don't believe in that. I'm gonna love you, and I'm gonna embrace you with love. I'm going to, you may believe in Buddha or Allah or whoever you believe in, but Christianity frees people up to love them for who they are, despite of their color, their creed, their sexual orientation, but just to love them. And we let the Holy Spirit do his work, but it's just our job just to love people. Amen, Mark.
Oh, brother, that's amazing. I want to share one real quick story with you. One time we were doing a prison ministry where we go in for 4 days and we get to spend time with them. And we get about 60 guys. We call them brothers in blue.
Yeah.
And we let them share at the end what they found when they came. You know, these are men that have never known anything about Jesus, really, or didn't know him.
Yeah.
And this one young black brother stands up, and this is what he shared. He said, "The last time that someone hugged me, I was 12 years old."
Wow.
He said, "You guys came in here." He's about 21, 22. "You guys came in here, and you hugged me." He goes, "That's when I knew that Jesus was real."
Wow.
See, it's the power of love,
yeah,
brother. And that's the message that you're sharing,
amen,
with America. And I just thank God for you, brother. I'm,
amen,
praying for you. I pray for Donald Trump, that we can all just come together,
yes,
unified,
absolutely,
for America.
Absolutely. Mark, thank you so much for your call, and thank you for just pouring that words of love to us all that is listening. You're right, unified is the only way that we can defeat Hillary Clinton and the liberal, very liberal race baiting Democrats. We got to do it united and with love. Listen, I love you in Jesus' name, and go forth, continue to preach his gospel. We got Bob from California on the call, and I'm going to try to get through everybody as much as possible, simply because we started so late, and I wanted to, you know, to make it up to everyone that is watching. You guys are doing amazing. Thank you so much for your likes. I want you to keep clicking that like button. Keep supporting and subscribing to RSBN TV. Go ahead, and if you're on Twitter, if you're not following me on Twitter, then something's wrong. You got to be at Pastor Mark Burns. It's sitting right there on your screen. If you're not following me on Twitter, I really want to connect with you. And I try my hardest to respond to everyone personally, but I really want you to connect with me on Twitter. Hashtag Colors Unite. Let the world know that we're doing something that says we're going to get past the colors that divide us. And here at RSBN and here on the Colors Unite, we're focusing on those colors that unite us, and that is the red, white, and blue of America. Go, my friend.
Hello.
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 I can hear you loud and clear.
Okay. Yeah, I'm a small businessman from California, and I'm in the liberal capital of the world, and I've been, you know, listening to you guys here, and all I can say is I just hope and pray to God that Donald is the one that's going to change all this craziness that's going on, because that's all I can describe it,
is, yes,
crazy.
It,
you know,
is,
I've
crazy.
I've got 3 kids, and I'm out here on my own, independently in business, and by the grace of God that I'm able to
provide for my family, but I'm rare because I'm not on the dole. But I guarantee you this, if Donald doesn't become president, there's going to be a lot of things that people wish that never happened.
Yep.
It's going to come true because they better pray and hope to God that Donald does become president.
Yep.
Because Hillary Crooked Clinton, you know, I went over to a customer's house and I looked at them in the face and they said they were proud to vote for Hillary. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't believe what I was saying. I had to bite my tongue. And they're so deceived. It's almost like, you know, when you turn a light on.
Yeah.
And everything scatters. That's basically what it is when you're looking at the evilness that's out there.
Yep, yep. Well,
it's crazy.
It is crazy. You're absolutely right. But before I ask, I just want to give a shout out to Compton 2952. We're tearing with you in joys. We're loving you in Jesus' name, and we're tearing with you, tearing up those tears of joy. But you're absolutely right. It is crazy. It is crazy. It is crazy what is taking place. And I know Donald Trump, the hours and times of the days I spent with him, he is as authentic as you can get. The liberal media does not do a good job into painting that picture of who he really is. But he really loves America, and he really believes how to pull us out of our situation as a country and lead us back into a country as a country where people respect us again and people look to us as the big brother, not the abuser, but the big brother that's going to do right, and to put back our religious liberties that the Democrats have been taking away, and to bring economic empowerment back to our country. Where, you know, I'm from the South Carolina, and there's so many jobs that are gone, so many mills that are gone, there's so many production companies that are gone, and that's because of this, the Free Trade Act and what Hillary Clinton and the Democrats have been doing. Donald Trump is going to eliminate that. Trust me when I tell you, he is the right man. He loves America, and the moment he gets into office, you will immediately begin to see a change where there's small government and not big government, where things, powers are going back into the hands of the local community and the local cities and the local states, where we can do more for our own community. So trust me when I tell you, you don't get no more authentic person than Donald Trump. Thank you so much for calling in. I pray that helps out. Let's continue to fight and get him in. We're going to try to get through as many more calls as possible. We got Lola from Georgia. You're down the street from me from Georgia. Lola, are you there? If you can answer your question and then get off the line and we'll go to the next person. I really want to get to everybody as possible. So just ask your question to hang up and then we'll go to the next person. Go ahead, Lola. So happy you're here.
I didn't really have a question. I just wanted to say that I'm voting for Donald Trump.
Amen.
Because he is not a racist.
Yes.
And, you know, it hurts my heart that we're called racist. And I'm white, but I have a granddaughter. I have two great-grandchildren that are mixed, black and white. I have one daughter that's fixing to have a black son. And I just want people to know that just because that Hillary Clinton is, she's the one that's racist because she pretends to love somebody when she does not love anybody.
Yep.
She loves herself. And I just want you to know that I don't care what color anybody is. There's only one color in the eyes of God, and
yes,
that is red. The
Absolutely.
Blood of Jesus Christ that flows, that flows through all of us. It doesn't matter what our skin color is. There's only one color in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
And that is God's blood, red. So I want to thank you for the job that you're doing, and I love you so much for standing behind the man that is going to bring the real change to America. And so God bless you, and I'll get off the air, and thank you for taking my call.
God bless you so much. What powerful words, and you're so right. I believe we have more people like you and more brothers and sisters who are just loving on people despite of their color, and that's the key is love. We can overcome any form of racism. I believe a movement is starting right now. God is using Donald Trump to start that movement. and I'm so thankful to be a part of it. Thank you so much for calling. Brad from North Carolina. Brad from North Carolina. Brad, are you there, my friend?
Yes, sir. How are you doing tonight?
Doing good, wonderful, Brad. If you can make your statement, ask your question, and then we'll hang up.
Absolutely. I don't have any questions for you, but I'm from Raleigh, and I'm a huge Trump supporter, and yes. I love you and love what you're doing. I really appreciate everything that you're doing. I want you, every time that you see Trump, anytime you see him, just go up to him, put your hand on him, say a prayer for him, and say a prayer with him, and just let him know that everybody's with him, God is with him. I really do believe he is a godsend. I told him that he was a godsend the first time I saw him at a rally, and I don't know if he heard me or not, but I've been to like 8 rallies. I've actually met him in person once, and I met Eric once, and I met Diamond and Silk, and they're awesome. Diamond and Silk are so much fun. But anyways, yeah, I just want to talk about real quick, and I'll let you go. The DNC, the convention, all those people in there flying the Palestinian flags. I was just, one thing came to my mind while I was waiting on the phone with you. I wanted to bring it up. That girl, I think she was like 13 years old, that was stabbed to death in her bed at like 8 o'clock in the morning in Israel, by a Palestinian.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's so many terrible things going on in Israel right now. We really need to keep our eye on Israel, and we
absolutely
need to be behind them 100%, because Israel is God's country, is God's land over there. And God promised that he would protect his people. And so we really need to be behind them 100%. And
absolutely,
so I'm going to just say a prayer for all of us real quick, and I'm going to get off the phone, okay?
Go ahead.
So God, heal us all, forgive us all, forgive us for our sins, bring us through all these dark and tough times, give us strength in these times of need, and just let everybody know that God is in control, and there's nothing, nobody else is in control. It's only God. God controls everything. So there's no need to worry about what you're going through, about, you know, what the problems are in your life or what the problems are in the world. But you got to understand that this is God's world. This is God's. God created this universe. He created every one of us. So there's absolutely nothing to worry about. But I do, one more fact I'm going to bring up, okay? Amen. One more thing I'm gonna bring up, and then I've paid attention to a lot. I'm only 26, and I've paid attention to a ton of I've paid attention to a lot of elections. I've been a Republican ever since I was 18. You know, since I could sign up, but pretty much my whole life, whatever. But I've never seen an election where people have gotten so involved. Like right now, this has never happened for me. I've never called in to a live show.
Yeah.
You know, to pray with a bunch of fellow Trump supporters. I mean, I've never done, you know what I'm saying? You never saw that with Mitt Romney. You never saw this level of passion. It's never happened before. So I really think we're in times right now where, I mean, we're going to see something big.
Absolutely.
Now, I really believe this is the time we're going to see something big. So I want to say bless you. Thanks for everything you're doing. Hopefully one day I'll see you up on the stage with Joe Osteen, and have a good night.
Amen. Thank you so much. And you're absolutely right. You know, and I just want to just piggyback what you're saying. You know, I believe we're in the times. We've had to unite more than ever. And you're right. Something special is taking place. It is not normal what Donald Trump has done. And I believe the hand of God is upon his life. I'm not trying to make this a religious show or a spiritual show at all. But I do believe that the hand of God is most definitely upon Donald Trump. And I believe there's enough believers who are proud to be Christian, proud to be an American, proud to be men and women of faith, regardless of what that is. We're proud to have faith in our life. And Donald Trump is the only one that's bringing that back into the forefront. So thank you, brother, so much for calling in. Mm-hmm. Thank you. And I hope to see you. And I know we got a couple of rallies coming up in North Carolina. And I'll be, again, I'll be in Florida, Jacksonville, Florida this week. But then I'll be back in North Carolina. So I hope to get to meet you. Make sure you come up and see me so I can say hey to you.
I will.
God bless
definitely.
You so much.
Love you, man.
We got Tiger Fan from Alabama. I love you too, my brother. Tiger Fan from Alabama. I'm coming to you. Tiger Fan from Alabama, how are you today?
Oh, I'm doing fine, Pastor Burns. Thank you for having me on.
Yes.
Listen, what I wanted to talk to about the social media and the evil mainstream media today were exploding about this controversy between Khan and his wife at the Democratic Committee and what he said attacking Donald Trump. Of course, they're putting it all on Donald Trump.
Right.
And I myself think it was disgraceful what the man and his wife did in terms of putting their sons
death.
Sacrifice out there in the open and using it to pander for votes. That
absolutely
was really wrong, if you ask me.
Well, you
and
know,
then he claimed that Donald Trump doesn't know the Constitution.
Right.
Well, he needs to study the Constitution because it gives the president the power to control who comes into the United States. So he was absolutely wrong about that.
You know, I want to answer to that because I interviewed today about that very thing. And for those who are watching, and I'm going to try to be as brief as possible so we can get to as many people that we have on the call now. Thank you so much for calling in. But just to quickly do a quick recap. The Khan family, for those who watch the DNC, you know, it was a disgrace. It was a disgrace. It was sad, first of all, that they would use Hillary Clinton would use the emotionalism of the Khan family, and to use the death of their son, Captain Khan, who died, to throw it into Donald Trump's face like it was his fault. To do that, and then
and
exactly, and then for Mr. Khan to get up there and say, Mr. Trump, you've never read the Constitution, so here's a copy of mine. Well, first of all, that's a fabrication. I mean, it wasn't right for him to get up there and to declare a lie to millions of people that are watching to say, you know, here's my Constitution, you ought to read it. And, you know, and all it does is gets people excited in emotionalism when in reality it was Hillary Clinton's fault that her son died. Hillary Clinton is the one that had an indirect cause of his son's death. But yet they're on stage playing to the fact that he's a Muslim, like Donald Trump hates Muslims, and that's a lie too. Playing to the, you know, no, Mr. Trump is only responding to what Mr. Khan did. And that was a lie for him
to get
up on stage and to attack him first. And with a lie. I mean, I can understand if it was true, but with a lie, you know, on all sides. And the Clinton family should be ashamed. Hillary Clinton should be ashamed for using and manipulating that family's grief to pander after votes. That's all she did, and that's all she's going to continue to do. And we got to make sure she doesn't get in office. Thank you so much, Tiger fan, for giving me a call. Going to Scott from Alabama. Scott, I'm coming to you. Scott, are you there?
Yes.
Scott, so happy to hear you. Welcome to the show, yes, my friend.
Hey, I am, like, just so on fire for this channel. And I love Donald Trump, and I love how he's for all Americans.
Yes.
And there's no color.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, my friend, you found the right place here, RSBN.TV. We got to unite and come together and be.
I am here.
And we got to continue to unite, be strong, be vigilant. There are more Americans out there that are not focused on the colors of our skin, but there are more Americans who have the spirit of Dr. Martin Luther King, who says there's come a day where we're not being judged by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character. And you, sir, are a great American for standing with that. Thank you so much for calling
in. I appreciate it.
God bless you.
I appreciate you for saying that.
Amen. And continue to support the show. Continue to support RSBN TV. We're coming closer to the end. I'm not sure how many calls we have on the line, but we're coming closer and closer to the end because, I next week, I promise you, family, we'll be right on time at 7 o'clock so we can get in. I think I'm actually a little bit over than my hour show because I'm a little bit over an hour. My producer is shaking her head. Yes, Pastor, we're over an hour. But I'm really excited about everyone's calls. And I'm really excited about what is taking place here in America. And a movement is taking place. A movement. If you've been blessed and you've been moved by the show, two things. One, support RSBN.TV. Go and donate. They have a small staff. They work hard. They, as you can see, you're watching a lot of rallies that are taking place in the country, and it's because of them. They're working so hard to make sure that the bills are being paid. So donate, subscribe, connect with them, sow a seed into them. Also, don't you dare forget, you can't sow a seed into RSBN without sowing a seed into Donald Trump's campaign. We got to make sure he continue to raise money. We got to make sure that he's out there doing what he needs to do to make sure that our message, that he's our voice, he's speaking for us. so that his message, our message, is getting out there to the world, to the liberal media, who's going to do nothing but talk negative about Donald Trump. But America Voice is going to talk. America, we are the people of the United States of America, and our voice will be heard through Donald Trump. Make sure you're supporting the campaign. Make sure you're talking about the message, making sure that you're sowing and donating small seeds into the Trump campaign. I have Cheryl from Florida. Cheryl, how are you doing this evening, this 9 o'clock, 9:39 evening, Eastern Standard?
Hi, are you there?
I'm there, Cheryl. How are you?
I'm excellent. How are you?
I'm great, Cheryl.
Great. I just want to say thank you, Right Up, for Right Side. They're fantastic. They're kind of my new go-to social media people.
Yes.
And the work you're doing is awesome, too. And I just love Donald Trump. I just wanted to say just a couple of remarks here. You know, I do a lot of posting messages for Donald Trump from Right Side and so on and so forth. And I have another young lady she's a black gal. And we post a lot of stuff. And she has been so violently attacked by her own black community.
Yes.
Because she has contrary beliefs than they do. And I just feel it's so sad that we have to write apology letters.
Yep.
She has to say, hey, I'm going to vote for who I think is right. And she said she literally had to unfriend half of her people.
Yep.
But the tensions are high. And, you know, I just find that so many people do not want to do the research.
Nope.
They want to swallow this garbage the media is feeding them. And because it's easy, because they don't have to invest any time. And I just think it is, people need to wake up. They just need to wake up.
Absolutely.
And they need to listen.
Well, I'm going to say this first. Go ahead.
My friends, because I post so much. But I said it's a pivotal point in this election. We must share this information.
Yes. Yes. Well, let me just say this concerning your friend. I know exactly the pain she's going through. You know, it's very sad. And it's vexing to hear that, you know, especially within the black community, how many blacks in the community, you know, try to pretend as though whites are only racist when in reality, they you know, the black community is extremely racist, and a lot of us racist just towards your own people. And you know, because a racist comment is a racist comment. I've been death threats. I've been said, you know, I should go hang myself. You know, people who, you know, there are all kinds of comments that they make in this country, all over the country. And it's sad. It's true. That's why, you know, when people start saying, well, Donald Trump is racist, I've turned it back to them and say, well, what about the racist comments that I received from my own people? Let's first deal with that.
Yeah.
Okay, because racism.
Oh, they call her whitewash.
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
a lovely girl.
Yeah, Uncle Tom, all of it. It's very sad. It's very sad.
I get called a racist. I'm scared to put a Trump sticker on my car because there's been so many people's vehicles here in Jacksonville, Florida, that have had damage done because of you stating who you're for. So, I mean, that's terrible.
Well, I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to tell you this. Don't let nobody stop you. Don't let anybody, you know, again, you know who you're voting for. You know, be bold who you're voting for. Don't let nobody scare you, talk you out of. Just another side note, I heard you said you're in Jacksonville. I will be in Jacksonville this week, this Wednesday. I am going to be there. I hope to get to meet you. You make sure you get there early so I can put my arm around your neck and meet you in person at the Trump rally that's going to be in Jacksonville this Wednesday.
Are they going to hold that in Jacksonville?
You
have they decided yet?
They haven't decided yet. They're literally working on that as we speak, but I know in the next day or so you should know, but I want to make sure that I come and put my arm around your neck. So make sure you say, hey, Pastor Mark, I saw you. So make sure you get there really early because I want to hug you.
But thank you so much for what you do. And Right Side, they are just awesome. I just love them. And, you know, God bless Trump.
God bless you.
You know, he's doing the right thing and 100% behind him. And people just have to not listen to this dirty media stuff. It's
absolutely.
Just dirty laundry.
Absolutely.
You know.
Well, thank you, Precious, for calling in. I love you, and I hope to get to meet you really soon. Family, I'm coming closer and closer and closer to the end of this broadcast. I'm going to look at this camera here. I'm coming closer and closer to the end of this broadcast, and I want to make sure we have so many other callers on the other line, and I'm trying my hardest to get everyone. I do apologize for people who is not able to get through. Please, I pray that you don't hold it against me, because we're trying to get through as many people as possible. But I'm excited. I'm so honored. I'm so humbled that so many people are calling in from all over the country, because we are uniting this country together. We're uniting the people together. We are bringing, we're getting people focused on issues that are really dealing in our communities, because what happens to your community happens to my community. What happens in your life happens in my life. I have Brad on the call. This is my last call, North Carolina. Brad, are you there?
Yeah, I've already talked to you. I'm just still listening.
Okay, Brad. Well, I'm so happy you called in again, my friend.
I'm still on the line, man. I'm listening to you. I love you.
Okay. I love you too, Brad. I love you too. God bless you, man.
All right. Yeah. I'll see you on Fox in a minute, okay?
Yes, you will. See me on Fox. Listen,
right.
Family.
All right.
So, listen, we're going to be in Ohio. RSBN is going to be, thank you, Precious. RSBN is going to be broadcasting live at Trump Rally in Columbus, Ohio at 3 p.m. tomorrow, and in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania at 7 o'clock tomorrow. So for all you wonderful RSBN TV, you love watching Mr. Trump speak and his rallies tomorrow. There are two of them, one in Ohio, Columbus, Ohio at 3 o'clock, and the second one is going to be Harrisburg, Pennsylvania at 7 p.m. And then we got some things that we're working behind the scenes, but I'm really excited about what Mr. Trump is doing. I'm excited about what RSBN TV is doing. Listen, I love you all so much. You guys are so amazing. This show is going to be a continued success, and it's because of you, you callers calling in. You've been so patient with us for our very first time in doing it, and RSBN and Joe and the whole team and the whole staff, guys. I love y'all so much. And listen, as I'm about to go, I want you to click the like button. Click it. I'm told that we're going for a record here, so click that like button. Get on it quickly. Make sure you're spreading the news about RSBN TV. We want to get that subscribers up in the millions, and I believe we can do it together. If Mr. Trump, who got 10 million followers on Twitter, then I know for a fact we can get RSBN to over a million subscribers. So let's do it together. We are a family. I'm just also getting word that RSBN will also be in Florida. So in Jacksonville, too, it's going to be amazing. I know it's going to be at 7 o'clock. We don't have the location yet, but I know it's going to be an explosive time that we're going to have together. Again, go to Twitter. Follow me on Twitter, at Pastor Mark Burns. Or go to Facebook. Like me on Facebook. I'm posting stuff on Facebook all the time. And I know people who ask to be my friend on my normal profile, they only have a limit to 5,000 people. But if you go to the fan page, I think we're up to over 6,000 now. So if you want to connect with me on, because I'm literally posting stuff behind the scenes, pictures behind the scenes, you never know what's going to take place on Facebook or on Twitter. Make sure you're doing that, because I really want to connect with you. I try my hardest to respond to everybody, especially on Twitter. I try my hardest to respond to everybody that gets on. And so, listen, I love you all so much. Don't forget, I'm going to be on Fox News here in about 10 minutes. The show starts at 10 o'clock p.m. And then I think my segment is going to come on about 10:20 to 10:30. But make sure that you're watching, supporting that as well, because, our host, Jesse, was great. He was a great host. You could tell it was all great news about Mr. Trump, and so you don't want to miss it out. Fox News has been doing really great. So anyhow, I love you all so much. Also, go to my website, markburns.org. 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 Go check the website out. We're doing some bigger things in the body of Christ, and I'm just trying to continue to get the word out. So if you believe God, if you believe that you want to continue to help support that, just go to markburns.org, and I'd love to connect with you. We're thankful for all the people that have sold gifts and seeds into the ministry. All of that goes right back into the ministry for that. I am forever thankful for your gifts. Continue to help us get the word out there to the world. And listen, I am out of here. I am gone. It's Pastor Mark Burns. I'm signing off. For everybody that didn't get to get in, please, please, please forgive me. But we'll be back next Sunday at 7 o'clock on the great RSBN.TV, the Right Side Broadcasting Network, right here on this amazing channel. I'm Pastor Mark Burns, and you're watching The Colors That Unite. We're not going to focus on the colors that divide us, but focusing on the colors that unite us. We are the United States of America, and I'm proud to be an American. God bless you. Have an amazing night. We'll see you next Sunday.
There's only the one color that matters, and that is the color of red, white. Focusing on the colors that unite us, USA!
USA! USA! USA!